Well, we see that military search is still done by the dismounted soldiers with handheld detectors. When the suspected objects, the explosive hazards, are only at, let's say, 1 meter, 1.5 meter from the soldier itself. And with the use of the UAVs, we try to enhance or to enlarge the standoff distance from the operator to the explosive hazard.
We came out of Afghanistan and some of our allies out of Iraq are fighting the improvised explosive device battle. And so that was really focused on threats like emplaced IEDs in routes, buildings, infrastructure. And so we're going to replicate those here. It's a well understood problem. So we have a number of routes that are going to be cleared or proven safe.
There are sensors that are looking for ground disturbances, optical systems, but also radar systems. There are sensors that can detect the wires, the command wires, so that are very long wires into the site terrain, to a trigger man, for instance. There are sensors that are really aiming at detection of metal objects. Electronic components is an important one with the non-linear junction detection. And also change detection, so the changes between a pass over the route 2 days before and the current situation where the targets are in place.
Sadly, there is no silver bullet in counter ID. If there was, that would be easy. We buy one system and we're done. The technologies here, you see a lot of technologies. If all those technologies say the same thing about one object, things become better. With one sensor, we got a 60% chance that it is something. With two sensors, you can go up to 70, 80%. With three, 90. So it's more secure. It tells the soldier more about a specific object.
We have in total, I think, seven different sensor technologies in this trial. And there is not one sensor technology that covers all the threats. So every system will miss some of the targets. But we know that in the end, we will have to combine a smart combination of different sensors to cover all the targets.
I hope to see the results of all the detectors fused on one screen, that the soldier can say, hey, all the 9 or 10 detectors giving us a warning signal. So that means that probably there's an ID. That's what I want.
So the task group is mainly the military and mainly the scientists. The military with all their knowledge on the threat and the scenarios. The scientists with their knowledge on the interesting technologies to detect this threat. But we need also the industry, of course, because they have also a lot of interesting developments. And in the end, they will probably manufacture the systems that will be used by the soldiers.
We were in the audience and received a presentation from the Ukrainian army a number of years ago, talking about their experience in the Donbas and the threat of scatterable mines and their inability to clear them before being targeted by artillery, which is a time critical thing. So our system was derived to counter that scenario.
Interaction with our allies is absolutely fundamental. From a NATO perspective, we all get to see the evolution of the technologies as it's evolving. We start to understand and recommend to our own militaries the capabilities that they could expect to be able to access in the next few years. And it also allows us to coordinate our programs. And so that internationally, we're working more efficiently, we're sharing information, and we're advancing the whole field together as allies.
We have to be creative when new threat types pop up. That happens all the time during missions, of course, because our opponents look at us and they observe us and they see what type of technologies we are using. So they're smart guys, but we have to be smarter.